Just 11 days to go in the league phase. It is very much the business end now in the group stage of the IPL 2017. It's time to preview match number 41 here on ESPNcricinfo for Match Day T20. It sounds like a lot of cricket that we've had and spoken about. It's going to be with two men who turned 41 a few years back. That's Sanjay Bangar and Brad Hogg, just a few years back, not more than that. Thank God they're not on picture, now they are. But good to have you gentlemen, we'll get your thoughts in a second. Let's open match day, match point number one. It's Pune against Kolkata. Kolkata, of course, having lost to Hyderabad, they want to pick themselves up. It's very much a top four clash. And Pune, on the other hand, buoyed by the Ben Stokes result against Gujarat. Now, they're back at Kolkata where Nathan Coulter-Nile has been on a roll. So we start by talking about the Australian quick. Not necessarily your first choice pace selection if you looked at that squad. But if we look at the numbers, gents, with bowlers at the best strike rate, minimum of 10 wickets in this year's tournament, he's right up there ahead of Andrew Tye, Bhuvneshwar Kumar, who we've spoken so much about, Imran Tahir, who's been so good for Pune on the other hand, 8.29 the economy and a strike rate of 10. So he gets you a lot of wickets, especially at the Eden Gardens. Let's get Brad Hogg's thoughts first. The use of Coulter-Nile at the Eden Gardens, important. What about him and the Kolkata ground do you think makes a good combination? Off you go.
I think it's a great combination. The only thing that you'd like there, and you'd like to be greedy there, is just to bring that economy rate down, but you can't have everything. The thing that Coulter-Nile has changed is when he first came on the scene, he liked to bowl a lot of short deliveries. He very rarely pitched it up. Now he's pitching it up, trying to get some swing, trying to get that outside edge when he's got the new ball in the power play. And obviously when you do that, batsmen are going to get some boundaries, playing some straight drives and some cut shots. The other thing is, when it's the old ball, he's starting to get it reverse. And also, he's mixing his pace up now a lot better than what he did a year or two ago. He's starting to bowl some slower balls where he rolls those fingers over the seam and really bamboozling batsmen in those middle period overs.
Perfect. 45 seconds and Brad Hogg nails it. Let's get Sanjay Bangar's thoughts. The use of Coulter-Nile. He seems to have done most damage swinging that new ball, keeping it fairly simple. Has he set a template for how fast bowlers should go about it, especially at grounds like Eden Gardens? Your thoughts?
Fresh wicket. Bounce and see movement on offer on a KKR on a wicket in Calcutta, which is not really seen that much. So credit to Saurav for that, to make that sort of a wicket there. But apart from that, KKR strategy ever since Andrew Russell played for them was to have some bowler who will be aggressive, who will bowl the short ball, and Andrew Russell did that really, really well. And they were looking at a bowler, and here's the credit to the team management that they picked certain bowlers with a definite plan in mind, and that's where Coulter-Nile has fit the bill really well. Yep. He's using the short ball, attacking the batsman, hitting the lens really well, and taking wickets, which is what the captain requires.
Oh, what a start by both of you, just like Nathan Coulter-Nile. Two perfections, Sanjay Bangar and Brad Hogg, within their 45 seconds. Nathan Coulter-Nile, big weapon that Gambhir needs to use against Pune, which the batting of which is now seeming to get some form.